Hi, it's Parasymmetric Reviews, a tech channel, and I've got my Samsung Galaxy S4 acting a little weird. I think I got a bad app on it, and so I haven't gotten that far into setting it up. I've decided I just want to reset it to factory settings. Since I'm going to do that, I thought I'd show you how in case you need to erase everything on your phone and put it back to how it was when you first took it out of the box. Okay, if you can still get into the phone, you can do this from within the operating system. You're going to go to Apps and to Settings. And then in the tabs across the top, go over to Accounts. And the very bottom option here is Backup and Reset. And the option here near the bottom, Factory Data Reset. This will reset all settings and delete all data on device. So you will lose everything if you do this. Now, if you have a Google account, you've backed up your contacts and so forth, then it may all come back if it works properly, but you just better be sure you have a good backup if you're doing this and there's anything you need to keep. Also, anything that's in the memory, photos, videos, keep those things in mind. So be very careful once you get to this point. Once you start it going, there's no stopping it. All right, factory data reset. So here they're warning you, everything is going to be erased off the phone, music, photos, encryption keys, accounts, the whole thing. Down at the bottom, reset device. One last time, this will erase all your personal information and downloaded apps. Data cannot be recovered. If you're really, really sure, delete all. Say goodbye to all your stuff. Got our little Android friend. This is when low-level stuff is going on. And underneath of him, he says, erasing. Okay, we're back to our out-of-box experience here. Choose the language and set it all up again from scratch. Okay, that just took 2-3 minutes and it's back up to the main phone screen. It's back on the T-Mobile network because I have my SIM card in. If I had removed my SIM card, it would just be lost as to really where it was in the world. But the phone is now empty. The photo gallery shows there's no photos, there's no contacts, there's no call log. It's all gone. And if that's what you wanted, then you should be very happy. Now you've got to go back to setting it all up, customizing it, downloading your apps and so forth. Now, if this is not your case, if you weren't able to get into the software to run that reset, there is a way to do the hard reset via the buttons. Like if your phone has just gotten, if it's locked up, you can usually pop the battery out to get it to restart. But if it just will not load up into the operating system where you can get to those options to do it in software, let me show you how to do it in hardware. Okay, to wipe everything out in hardware, keep in mind this will wipe everything out. You'll lose all the photos, the videos, the contacts, the music. Everything will be gone from the phone when you're done with this. So be sure you have it backed up. Be sure this is something you really want to do. First of all, you'll need to know where the power button and the volume buttons are. The power button over here and your volume up and down are over here. The way you initiate this process, which is basically booting into the subsystem underneath of what you normally see on the phone. Start with the volume button over here, volume up, you want to hold that. The menu button down here in the bottom center, that's got to be held at the same time too. And then you've got to get another finger over to the power button. We're pressing all three simultaneously until we see the Samsung logo. We're waiting on that, let go, and now you see the blue up here in the corner. That means it's coming into recovery mode. And there we are. Now the typeface is very small up in the top to see what's going on.
Yeah, I can't really get it any closer to the camera here. You might need a set of reading glasses to be able to make out what it says, but I can tell you if you're just going for the reset, and remember this will erase everything on your phone, it's not, you don't touch on the screen, instead you use the volume up and down rocker, and you're going to go down three options. The first one that it's on is reboot system now. We go down one. That's apply update from AOB or AO8. Down another one, apply update from external storage. Down another one. So at this point, we've gone down three. With the volume down, we've gone down three. And it says wipe data / factory reset. And that's the one we want. So we've come down three with the volume to select the reset. And now to select it, touching the screen doesn't work. So you go over to the power and you press it once to select that reset and erase all data. And it says delete all user data. And there's no, 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 no. Yes, no, no, no. They don't want you to do this accidentally, or rather they don't want to do it to you accidentally. So I'm going to go down through all the no's till I get to the one that says yes, delete all user data. And again, I'm going to select it with the power button over here. Now it says wiping data, formatting data. It's all going bye-bye at this point. There's no stopping it. Underneath the little Android guy, it says erasing. Data wipe complete. The options now up above, we're going to choose the first one, which it automatically went to, which is reboot system now. And to select it, I'm going to press the power button. Rebooting. Take off my reading glasses now. Takes a little bit of time here while it sets everything back up. It'll be a minute or so. So here we are, about a minute and a half later, back to the very first screen from when you turn it on right out of the box. It's back to its out-of-the-box freshness. You get to reset it, have another go at it, and hopefully whatever went wrong the first time doesn't go wrong again.